Inside Excel, there's a special tool called VBA that can make your life a lot easier, but most people are scared to use it because it looks very different from normal Excel. So in this video, I'm going to show you how easy it is to get started with VBA and make it work for you. VBA stands for Visual Basic for Applications. It's a programming language that helps you to automate Excel. Most Excel users never use it and think of it as an advanced skill, but it's not as hard as it seems if we start with a simple recorded macro. First, I'm going to add the Developer tab. So I'll right-click up here and click on Customize the Ribbon. And now scroll down till I find Developer and check that box. Then click OK. Now we have a new menu called Developer with Visual Basic and Macros. So I have a list of names, but they're not properly capitalized. I'm going to replace them with the proper capitalization like this. And to do that, I'll record a macro. But before we start, we've got to use relative references. So I'll click on this button. And that means even if we record the macro in cell A2, we'll be able to apply it to A3, A4, A5, and so on. Now we're ready to record. So I'll click on Record Macro. And I'll choose a name for it in this box. Convert to proper case. And I use a shortcut, Shift P. So when I press Control Shift P, it will run this macro. I'll store the macro in this workbook, because all a macro is just a recorded series of actions that Excel will play back. And I'll create a description, convert text to proper case, and click OK. And take your time when recording a macro to make sure you're deliberate about each action, because Excel will try to remember everything you do. So I'll press the right arrow and enter a formula in B2. Equals proper, and then click A2, close bracket. Press Control Enter to keep this in the same cell here and not move down. And that's got it properly capitalized. I want to cut it back into A2. To do this, I'm actually going to copy it first with Control C, use the left arrow to get back to A2, then press Control Alt V to paste special, and choose values, and then click on OK. Now I'll right arrow and delete here, and then press left arrow so we go back to cell A2. Now we can stop recording. Let's test this out on another name. I'll click on Mary Jones, then press the shortcut Control Shift P. Yes, it worked. Now I'll select Michael Brown, Control Shift P. Again, it worked. And that's what macros are good for. They replay the actions you recorded. Now to make sure your recorded macros are saved in your workbook, you've got to save them in File, Save As, and then choose an Excel macro enabled workbook like this, and then choose a name for it. Otherwise you'll lose your recorded macros. But what happens when we try to use that macro on more than one cell? So I've selected these 6 cells and I'll press Control Shift P. Watch what happens. Only the first cell, Sarah Davis, is changed. The others are not changed. And that's why we need to look at VBA, which gives us the power to write our own automations instead of just relying on recorded actions. I'll switch to the Visual Basic Editor by clicking on the Visual Basic button. Now, the first time you see this interface, you'll feel confused because it's not like Excel at all. Don't let that stop you. It's easy when you know what the main parts are called and what to use them for. Here we have the Project Explorer. This is where you see the open files and folders. Next is the Properties window, and this shows you the properties of the objects that are selected in the Project Explorer. So in this case, we actually have Sheet 1, which is called Test, selected, and you can see Sheet 1 is the name property. Then we have the menu bar at the top where you can access commands like saving files or viewing code. Then we have toolbar buttons down here, which you can actually take out. If I click on this, I can actually take out this toolbar and then put it back in. So this gives very nice access to commands that you'll use quite often. But where's the code? I'm glad you asked. I'm going to double click on this thing called Module 1, and it opens the code window, which is where our code lives. So you can see the recorded macro here. All of this is the Visual Basic code that Excel recorded automatically when we hit the record macro button. This green text here is called comments that we can read as humans, but Excel doesn't run. And everything else here is the code that Excel does run. Now, what was the problem with our recorded macro? If you remember, if we selected more than one cell, it would only operate on that first cell. So let's fix that with code. So I'll write some new VBA code, and don't worry too much about what it means. The important thing is for you to see that it's just text in the code editor, just like I'd say write in Notepad or Word. So here I'm just creating a new subroutine. You notice the name of the macro that we recorded is convert to proper case, and our new subroutine has added this word all just to distinguish it from the recorded macro. So every macro has to have its own unique name. Dim cell as range, I'm creating a container that's called cell, and that will hold things that are called range objects. So they're either cells or multiple cells. So with this line, I'm going to loop through every cell in the selected range. And I'll press tab here. So I'm going to do an if check. So if the cell isn't empty and the variable type is a string type, then we'll do this next line, which is to change the value of the cell using the application worksheet function. So in this case, application is Excel, and worksheet function, there's a group of functions that we can use inside our VBA program, and the function we're calling is called proper. So that will take the cell's value and change it to the proper capitalization. Now we close off that check. If the cell isn't empty and it's a type string, then we're going to convert it to a proper case. And this last line just means we'll keep going through this loop until we've done all the cells in our selection. The first time you see VBA code like this, it looks intimidating, but it's just instructions that Excel understands and follows. Very soon, you'll learn the VBA language for yourself as you watch more of the videos on my channel, or you could join my online course to make the whole process much faster and easier. Check the link in the description below to find out more. But the real question is, does this new code do the job? So now I'll head back to Excel by clicking on the Excel icon. And notice that if I click on Visual Basic, I can toggle between the two like this. Then I'm going to click on the Macros button, and it's showing me Convert to Proper Case, which is our recorded macro. I'm going to change the options here and just delete the shortcut key, pressing backspace. Then click OK. Then go to Convert to Proper Case All, which is the subroutine we just wrote using VBA, which is Visual Basic for Applications. And here I'll click on Options, and I'll choose Shift-P as a shortcut key for this macro, and then click OK. So this subroutine, although we've called it a subroutine, is also known as a macro. It's something that Excel can read and run. So that first macro is one we've recorded with the macro recorder up here. And this second macro is the one we wrote ourselves using Visual Basic for Applications, or VBA. So now I've done that and applied the shortcut key Control-Shift-P, I'm going to close this so we can test this out. Let's select Daniel Wilson and press Control-Shift-P. It worked. Now let's try it on three cells. So Jessica, Robert, and Emily. Again, I'll press Control-Shift-P. And yes, this time it worked. So before with the recorded macro, it would only do the first cell, but this time it's done all three. Let me choose all of the remaining cells and see what happens if I press Control-Shift-P. And it handled it, no problem. So just a quick note, when you run a macro, there is no undo generally, so you have to make a backup of your data in case you need to go back to an earlier version. I have an earlier version of the name list here, so I'll just copy it across into our test sheet, which is this one. Press Control V, and we can try it again. So press Control Shift P. There we go. It's changed John Smith's name, and I can select all of these, and then press Control Shift P, and ta-da, it works. So with just a few lines of code, we've been able to create a new tool that converts text to proper case. But that's just a very basic application of VBA. I cover a lot more in my online course. So if you're interested in automating tasks and regaining control of Excel, do check it out in the description below. However, we're not done yet. I'd like to show you some useful shortcuts that make it easier to use VBA. If you learn these now, you could save hours later. Let's start with a shortcut to toggle between the VBA editor and Excel. So you already know that you can click on the Visual Basic button, but you can also press Alt and F11, which is my favorite shortcut. So this is going to be your front door to VBA, and you just press Alt and F11 to switch back to Excel. So if you don't learn any other shortcuts, just make sure you learn Alt and F11. Next, a little bonus tool. You won't use it much at first, but do keep it in your back pocket. So you press Control and G to open something called the Immediate Window, where you can test small bits of code. And it's called the Immediate Window because, like its name suggests, it does things immediately. So here's a taster. I'm going to type in question mark space now, then press enter. And that brings up the current system time and date. Or I could write in 25 times 4 and hit enter. And if you need any quick maths, just ask and the answer comes out. Or I could type in something like this, question mark range, open bracket, A2, close bracket, dot value, hit enter, and it says John Smith, which shows you can peek at what's inside your spreadsheet. Now there's a whole lot more you can do with the immediate window, which gets more useful as you write more programs. And to bring it up, remember, just press Ctrl and G. But for now, it's enough to glimpse at what's possible. And it's time to move on to the next topic, which is, how do you learn VBA when you're just starting out? Well, you can go it alone. Try things out. Copy code from the internet. Use AI tools. And honestly, that can work, especially if you like figuring things out by yourself. But since you're watching this video, I take it that you want some more personal guidance from someone like me, who has an online course that teaches Excel VBA. However, here's the thing that most online course creators don't talk about. What do you do when something doesn't work? Because watching a video is one thing, but when your screen doesn't match what the instructor is showing, it can be frustrating and confusing. And you're left thinking, what did I do wrong? And that's why the personal support that I provide in my course will make all the difference. For example, take a look at what happened to Prabha in Module 3, Lesson 2. He was trying to arrange the VB editor windows, and no matter what he tried, they wouldn't snap into place. So what did I do? I didn't send him a generic link or tell him to Google it. I opened my own editor, hit record, and made a personal Loom video walking him step by step through the process. That video helped him to quickly sort out his issue with confidence. And that's the level of support I like to bring to every student in the course. Here's another example from Module 4, Lesson 4, when a student asked, how do I change this paste special macro so it runs relative to the cell you're in instead of always pasting to the same cell D6? That's a great question because it shows they're starting to think in terms of flexibility. And it gave me the perfect time to tell them about the offset property. I gave them the VBA code and explained the logic behind what offset does and what the numbers mean. And then suddenly, that student didn't just fix one macro, they learned a new skill that they'll be able to use in future automations. And there are dozens more examples just like that in my course. It's designed to help you learn VBA and start automating Excel without the struggle. But you don't just learn from videos, you actually get my personal support. And I've helped more than 500 students and have a Trustpilot rating of 4.5 stars. So if you're ready to check it out, click the link below. But if you want more free tips, I've got you covered too. In the next video, we'll dive into some advanced VB editor hacks that will save you time and make you feel like a pro. I'll see you there.